around. I'm actually waiting for my group of friends. We're all from South Jersey, so we all came here a little bit differently. You know, personally, I thought it best to park in South Philly to make it quicker.
Just in case Philly PD decided to shut down the railroads, I could get home safely.
So I drove into the city. I'm so excited for today. This is not my first march. I actually went to D.C. when Bush was reelected
to protest his presidency. But
I went to Washington, D.C. for that. So I'm excited to protest in Philadelphia. I'm excited to stand up for my rights as a woman. Proud and honored to do so. Because I have two girls and I want to protect their rights. So far, the gentleman who is in office, who holds the highest elected position in our country, is threatening to take away those rights in nearly every act he's done since becoming a GOP candidate. So today we march, we stand together. Today we try to educate one another on how to change local government. And today we try to make a big enough statement to make him realize that we are not going to take his shit for 4 years. Period. End of story. Hi, Russia.
There's a flavoring homeless man right now. Talking a bunch of shit.
Where the march starts. Right now I am in front of City Hall, just taking it in and waiting for the other people in my group to show up. There'll be four of us, but I'm sure by the end of the day there'll be many more of us. Like I said, it's pretty dreary and cold. The police presence is starting to become a little more heavy now. I do go home and cook and raise babies, but guess what? I have my own independent thoughts and wishes for not only my life, but my own life. Alright, so I'm going to sign off for now, but if you want to check back, follow me. I will broadcast live from the next March.